God bless you guys. I haven't looked to see if the video I did asking for prayer is up yet. I hope it goes up. If it's not up already, I hope it goes up soon. I need your prayers. I really need your prayers. Do you know, you guys are so special and I so need your prayers. I'm here on my own and the city, York, UK today is full of people. And a lot of them are drunk. So if you think this t-shirt is anything satanic, it isn't. It's got a compass on it, that's all. So don't worry about that. So here I am, I'm about to preach the gospel. I've got some Bibles down here. I'm on my own. I'm a bit nervous, but here we go. If you turn it on.
God bless you. God bless you, York. I am here to tell you that the living God loves you very much. I've come here to tell you how simple it is to be saved and know that you are going to heaven and not going down to hell for eternity. I have come here to tell you the good news. That there is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes.
Taking the mark of the beast.
I'm here to tell you the gospel of Jesus Christ, because the Bible says that we all have sinned and we all fall short of the glory of God, and that the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is everlasting, eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord for anybody and everybody who believes. Lay hold of your salvation. Jesus Christ is coming. Are you sure of where you spend eternity? If you do not wake up tomorrow, if you draw your last breath today, do you know where you will spend eternity? Because there is a heaven and there is a hell, and God wants none of you to perish in hell, and he's made it so simple for you to be saved and know you're going to heaven. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son Jesus, that whosoever believes on him should not perish but have everlasting life. The Bible says that there is no forgiveness of sins without the shedding of blood. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son Jesus to shed his blood, to be sacrificed for us on the cross, to pay the debt in full for all our sins. He was buried, he rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you will confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, come into my life, Lord Jesus, and you believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you repent and change your minds, you will all perish. There is a heaven and there is a hell. God wants none to perish in hell, and all can be saved, no matter who we are, no matter what we have done. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Come over here, Andrew, say hello to the people, because they've all been asking about you. Is it Andrew?
So I don't know how long I'm going to spend, but I'm just going to continue preaching.
Yeah.
Yes, it's very hot and muggy.
Yeah. Thank you. Pisses me off to come down that dissonance. I really get annoyed with that.
You know, you saved me last time.
Yeah.
He saved me. You saw it on camera. He saved me from a guy who was cursing and everything, wasn't he?
Yeah. They haven't got anything nice to say. Just walk past, you know.
You don't have to say anything bad, do they? You just have to. That's what I say to them. If you don't like the message, you only have to walk on. So, it's nice to see you, Andrew.
Yeah.
If Father God, I pray your blessing today, reminding that you love him so much, Lord, that you bless him, keep him, let your face shine upon him, be gracious unto him, Lord, lift up the light and beauty of your countenance upon Andrew and give him peace. In Jesus' name, amen. Thank you for him, Lord, and bless him abundantly, amen. Right, I'll just get going. Come back to me later if you want. Yeah, all right. God bless. What's going on now? It's not working. God bless. God bless. Oh dear, the microphone's suddenly not working now.
God bless. Oh, there it is. God bless you, York. I have come here to tell you the most important message that you will ever hear in this life, and it is the gospel of Jesus Christ. Because by believing it, you will be granted everlasting life, and you will escape the damnation of hell. It's not about religion, and it doesn't matter what you're doing, what you've done, all can be saved. Go to Jesus, and he will abundantly receive you and pardon all your sin. Because the Bible makes it expressly clear that we all have sinned. The Bible also makes it clear that the wages of sin is death, the destruction of the soul in hell for eternity. But the free gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes. It's not about going to church every Sunday. That will not save you. The only thing that will save you is the shed blood of the Lord Jesus Christ. Jesus was crucified on the cross to pay the debt in full for all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried and rose again from the dead on the third day according to the scriptures. And if you confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind and repent, you will not see the kingdom of heaven. You will not see the kingdom of God. Repent, therefore, change your minds, for the kingdom of God is at stake here. Your soul is at stake here. Your decision to accept or reject the free gift of God, everlasting life through Jesus Christ, will determine where you spend your eternity, because there is a heaven and there is a hell. Please accept the Lord Jesus. Time is short. The Lord Jesus Christ is about to descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will be resurrected first. And then all believers which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord Jesus in the air in the rapture. Don't be left behind. Believe the gospel of Jesus Christ and you will be saved and your house. The gospel is that Jesus was nailed to the cross to shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins according to the scriptures, past, present and future sins. When you believe, he was buried, he rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind and repent and believe the gospel, that you will all perish. Why would you wait until you're in hell before you realize how real it is? It will be too late then. Please, I urge you, I implore you, the Lord Jesus Christ is coming. And then this world is going to be turned upside down. First, the Lord Jesus shall descend from heaven, and he shall gather up to heaven all Christians who have ever believed on him in the rapture. And then, according to the prophet Isaiah, this world shall be turned upside down when God shall pour out his wrath and his judgments upon this world in 7 years of tribulation. A world, an unbelieving world, an unrepenting world, which has turned its back on our Holy Father in heaven. Let the wicked forsake his way, and the unrighteous man his thoughts, and let him return unto the Lord and unto our God, for he will abundantly pardon. Turn to the Lord Jesus while you have breath in you. The most important decision you should ever make in this life is lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of where you're spending eternity, heaven or hell. Be sure of your eternal security and believe the gospel, for there is no other name under heaven given to us by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the light, and no man comes to the Father in heaven but through me. Without Jesus Christ, you will find yourself in hell. This is the plain truth. Jesus wants to give you his free gift, which is everlasting life. No matter what you have done, go to him, call upon Jesus. Believe the gospel that he was indeed sacrificed on the cross for all our sins. He was buried. He rose again on the third day. Believe this in your heart. Call upon Jesus and you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind and repent, you will all perish. Repent means to change your mind from unbelief and believe the gospel. Nobody is guaranteed their next breath. Nobody is guaranteed to be here tomorrow. When you draw your last breath, you will go to the judgment seat of the Almighty God, and without Jesus Christ to repay the debt for all your sin, you will not be granted access into heaven, and you will find yourself in hell, a place of outer darkness, where there is weeping and wailing, where there is gnashing of teeth, where the worms never die, and the fire never goes out in hell. And your decision to reject the Lord Jesus will send you straight to hell. God is not willing that this should happen to any of you. God is love, but God has given us free will. He's given us a choice either to accept or reject the free gift of God, which is everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord. For there is no other name under heaven given among men by which we must be saved. Jesus Christ said, I am the door, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man. Jesus Christ is coming. This world is about to be turned upside down in what the Bible describes as the Great Tribulation. 7 years of hell on earth, when God shall pour out his judgments and his wrath upon this unbelieving, unrepenting world, which has turned its back on the living God. Any moment now, and the Lord Jesus Christ shall descend from heaven. He will gather up into heaven all who have ever believed on him in the rapture. And if you witness a great vanishing of people, you will still be able to be saved. But you must not take the mark of the beast, because during the 7 year tribulation, this man will come on the world stage, proclaiming himself to have all the answers, proclaiming himself to be the savior of the world. He will say, I am the Christ, but he is the Antichrist. and he will cause everyone, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hands or in their foreheads. 666. You won't be able to buy or sell anything unless you have the mark in your right hand or in your forehead. But if you take it, you will be cast into the lake of fire, which is the second death. Please lay hold of your salvation. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Be sure of where you are spending your eternity. Because this life and what you see is not all there is. There is a heaven and there is a hell. And your decision to reject the King, the Lord Jesus, will send you straight to hell. And God is not willing that this should happen. Please repent, believe the gospel, lay hold of your salvation. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Jesus Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation for anybody and everybody who believes. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ and you will be saved. Reject the Lord Jesus Christ and you will find yourself in hell. Repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. This is the most important message that you will ever hear. You're listening to it right now, and it is the gospel of Jesus Christ, that Jesus was sacrificed on the cross for all our sins, past, present and future sins. He was buried, he rose again from the dead on the third day. And if you believe this in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you repent, change your mind, you will all perish. Repent therefore, for the kingdom of God is at hand. This isn't a joke. This is a matter of heaven and hell. This is a matter of life and death. Your decision to accept or reject the Lord Jesus is the most important thing. Please do not reject the Lord Jesus, because you will find yourself in hell. Because Jesus Christ said, I am the way, I am the truth, and I am the life. No man shall make it to heaven but through the Lord Jesus Christ, who said, I am the door. Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man, because the clock is ticking. Tick tock, tick tock. Time is almost up. This is the last call into the kingdom of God before the rapture of the church takes place. Because any moment now, and the Lord Jesus Christ himself is going to descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel and the trumpet of God, and Jesus will gather up into heaven anybody and everybody, all who have believed on him in the rapture. The rapture is about to take place. Please repent, lay hold of your salvation. Jesus Christ is coming. The time is up. Jesus Christ is about to descend and take all believers up into heaven in the rapture. Don't be left behind. If you are left behind, you will still be able to be saved. But you must not take the mark of the beast in your right hand or in your forehead. For if you do, you will be cast into the lake of fire. Many of you are taking a gamble that heaven and hell are not real. Many of you are taking a gamble that Jesus Christ is not who he says he is, the way, the truth, and the life, and the only name under heaven given to us by which we must be saved. Many of you have gambling, and I'm sorry to say, many of you will only find out how real hell is when you are in there, because you chose to reject the Lord Jesus and his free gift, which is everlasting life for anybody and everybody who believes. The spirit of Antichrist is rising. That's because we are at the end of the age of the dispensation of God's grace. All what you see is about to be changed. In a twinkling of the eye, everything will change. Jesus shall take all believers up into heaven in the rapture, and then 7 years of literal hell on earth will take place, when God shall pour out his wrath and his judgments upon an unbelieving, unrepenting world which has chosen to turn its back on the living God. 7 year tribulation is what is about to begin. And this one world leader will come on the world stage, proclaiming to have all the answers. He will say that I am the Messiah, but he is the Antichrist. And the Antichrist will cause everyone to receive a mark in their right hands or in their foreheads. The mark of the beast, 666. You won't be able to buy or sell unless you have the mark in your right hand or in your forehead. But if you take it, you will be cast into the lake of fire, which is the second death. Repent, lay hold of your salvation. Jesus said, if any man is ashamed of me and of my words in the sinful, adulterous generation, of him also shall the Son of Man be ashamed when he comes in the power of his Father with the holy angels. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Lay hold of your salvation. Jesus loves you. He doesn't want you to spend eternity in hell, in outer darkness, where there's weeping and wailing and gnashing of teeth, where the worms never die and the fire never goes out. God is not willing that you spend eternity in the lake of fire. God is not willing that you spend eternity in hell, completely cut off from God, completely cut off from all light and everything that is good for eternity. Repent, lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of where you are spending eternity, heaven or hell, and you have the choice. God wants you in the kingdom of heaven, and all can be saved, no matter who you are, no matter what you have done. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus shall be saved. Be a whosoever. Don't gamble your soul straight to hell, because without the Lord Jesus Christ, that's where you'll go. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life, and no man shall make it to heaven but through the Lord Jesus. The only other alternative is hell. God doesn't want you to spend eternity in hell. God wants all to be saved. All can be saved. The Bible says that all can be saved, and that God wants all to be saved. And it's all down to you and your free will and your choice. Please make the right choice, because this life is just for a moment, but eternity is forever. Think about it. Lay hold of your salvation. Be sure of your eternal destination, heaven or hell. The choice is yours. The only requirement for you to make it into heaven is to believe the gospel in your heart. How? That Jesus died for all our sins according to the scriptures. He was buried. He rose again on the third day according to the scriptures. And if you confess Jesus as Lord and say, yes, I believe, Lord Jesus, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. That's how simple it is to know you're going to heaven. That's how simple it is to be saved. And once you are saved, you'll never lose your salvation. But Jesus said, unless you change your mind, unless you repent, you will not see the kingdom of heaven, and you will see hell. Without the Lord Jesus, you will go to hell. This is the truth of God's word. Because the Bible makes it very clear that we all have sinned. We all fall short of the glory of God. And that the wages of sin is death. But the free gift of God is everlasting, eternal life through Jesus Christ for anybody and everybody who believes.
The Bible.
The Bible makes it clear there is no forgiveness of sins without the shedding of blood. And God so loved the world, he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus, to be sacrificed, who shed his blood on the cross for the forgiveness of all our sins, according to the scriptures. He was buried. He rose again from the dead on the third day, according to the scriptures. And if you confess Jesus as Lord and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. But Jesus said, unless you change your minds, you will all perish. There is a heaven and there is a hell. And your choice to accept or reject the Lord Jesus will determine which one you spend eternity in. Please repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. Lay hold of your salvation. Do you know that you have the choice where you spend eternity? There is a heaven and there is a hell, and there's only one name under heaven given to us by which we can be saved and enter into heaven. And it is Jesus Christ who said, I am the way, the truth, I am the life. Jesus said, I am the door. By me, if any man shall enter in, he shall be saved. Be an any man, be an any woman. Stop gambling away your souls. You're gambling your soul to hell. Stop listening to the God of this age, Satan, whispering in your ear. The devil, Satan, is trying to distract you away from laying hold of your salvation through Jesus Christ. Stop listening to the whisperings of the enemy, Satan. He's trying to distract you away from laying hold of your salvation through Jesus Christ. Please stop listening to the God of this age, Satan, who has come to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come that we might have life, and that we might have it more abundantly, even everlasting, eternal life for anybody and everybody who believes the gospel. The gospel is that Jesus was nailed to the cross for all our sins. He was buried. He rose again on the third day. And if you believe this in your heart and call upon Jesus, you will be saved. But if you don't, you'll end up in hell. Please make the right choice, heaven or hell. The choice is yours.
28 minutes. Right, I'm going to stop this, guys. You can see the kind of crowd that I'm dealing with. They're mostly all right, though. I'm going to go and get a coffee, so I'll upload this one, and I'll be back soon. God bless you. We have the victory. Whatever happens to us, whether we live or whether we die, we have the victory, because we are saved. We are more than conquerors through Jesus Christ, who loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor demons, nor any other creature shall ever be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. See you soon, guys.